Hello, everybody. So today we're going to be looking at how to find the centroid and moment of inertias of a cross section using AutoCAD. We're going to be doing this using AutoCAD as well as SolidWorks in another video, just because those are the two of the most common programs used in professional engineering, and we want to be able to show how to do it using both. And which one you use really depends on what discipline you are in engineering. I tend to use SolidWorks more, but it's really depending on the discipline and even the company. So right now, we want to look at this problem. So we have a cross-section that looks like this here, with a hole, a rectangle cross-section with a rectangular hole in the middle. And what we want to find is, A, we want to find the centroid of this thing. I'm just going to, for fun, say it's right here. I don't know. And then when we find the centroid, we want to find the moment of inertias about the axes caused by about the axes at the centroid. So if we took the centroid wherever it is and drew x and y axes, we want to find the moment of inertia about those axes. So we can do that using AutoCAD. So we'll start a new drawing, pressing this new drawing tab up here. And it'll load us into something that looks like this. So the first thing we want to do is draw a rectangle that will be the outer rectangle of the thing. So from here to here. We're not going to worry about the hole just yet. So if we add up these dimensions, we see that this is actually 5 inches and this is 8 inches. So we want to make the lower left hand of the drawing the origin, which you should always do when you use this method. So because of that, we will specify the first corner point as 0, 0. And then we'll specify the other corner point as 5, 8. And again, remember that AutoCAD is unitless. It has numbers, and you use dimensions as numbers, but it doesn't care what dimension you're using. So as long as you keep track of what that is, it doesn't matter. So we know we're using inches, and we'll just remember that we're using inches. So we have our outer rectangle here, and we want to draw our inner rectangle, which is going to be the hole. And we see that the lower left hand of this is 0.9 inches in the x direction from the origin and 1.8 inches up from the origin, because remember the origin is right here. So we'll minimize that, and we'll draw another rectangle with the first corner point at 0.9, 1.8. Oh, I'm sorry, I think I did that wrong. 0.9, 1.8. And we will specify, instead of specifying the other corner point, we're actually just going to specify the dimension. So we'll press D, enter, and we'll specify the length. We know the length is 2 inches and the height is 5 inches. So the length will be 2 and the height will be 5. It calls it the width, but we know what we're talking about. And it'll generate that. So we will click to generate. So now we have our cross-section, but we're not done just yet because this cross-section, AutoCAD doesn't know that this is a hole. This is the hole in the middle of the cross-section, but we need to specify that. So what we're first going to do is we have to do something called region. We have to apply a region to this drawing. So we will type region, enter, and we'll select the objects. So right now, the first region is going to be the entire rectangle. So we'll select this outer rectangle, and we'll hit enter. And then we'll create another region that is the hole. So we'll type region again, and select this object, and press enter. So now we have our two regions. But now if we look, we can change our visual style. So we can type visual styles. We can select the conceptual view. And we see that this is what the cross-section looks like. It doesn't have a hole. It's just thinking that this outer rectangle is the cross-section, and that's not correct. So we have to actually subtract the inner region from the outer region. And we do that by typing subtract, and we first select the outer object. So we'll select this rectangle, we'll hit enter, and then we'll select the inner, what we're subtracting. So we're subtracting everything in here, and we'll click that, enter. And that will subtract it. So now if we go back to the conceptual view, we'll see that now we have a cross-section with a hole in it, which is what we wanted in the first place. And the reason why I'm switching the visual styles is because you can't really tell that too well when using the 2D wireframe, which is the default mode. But that is okay. We can switch to this by just typing visual styles in the command bar. Okay, so now that we have this, we have our cross-section. So the main command we want to use is called massprop. So we're going to type massprop, enter. And we're going to select our object, which is now showing up as one entire thing here. We'll select our object, hit enter, and we get our results back. So these results show up in your command bar, your command line here, but you can actually save these to a file. So you can save these, if you hit yes, you'll save them as a text file, but we don't need to do that right now just because we're doing this video. So if we look, we see that it gives us the area, which is 30 inches squared. And again, remember, it's not giving us any units, but we know what the units are just because we know we're using inches. So the perimeter is 40 inches, and it gives us all this good information, but most importantly, it gives us the centroid. Now the centroid is in, these dimensions of the centroid are in relation to the coordinate system that we defined, the origin of the coordinate system. So remember, we drew the lower left-hand corner of this rectangle at the origin. So these are relative to that. So the x is 2.7 inches that way, and the y is 3.9 inches up, which gives us the centroid. So you just have to remember where those are relative to. And then the moments of inertia, now this is kind of confusing, because here, these are moments of inertia about the x and y axes of the origin. So these are actually not what we want. We wanted to find the moment of inertia about these axes, the centroidal axes. But luckily, AutoCAD calculates that as well. And if this goes away, you can get it back by clicking this arrow, and it'll come back up. So actually, we want to find the principal moments and xy directions about centroid. That is the answer that we want. So we see that the i-axis, which is actually going to be the x-axis at the centroid, the moment of inertia about that axis is 191.3 inches to the fourth. And the j, the principal moment about the j-axis, which is the y-axis at the centroid, is 75.2 inches to the fourth. So these are the moment of inertia that we want, not these. So just make sure that whenever you're using AutoCAD to find the moment of inertia about the centroid, we want to be using these values, unless if we do want them about the universal XY axes, then you could use these values. But just that's kind of confusing, so just make sure that you always take these values when you're dealing with the centroid, which is usually what you're dealing with. And again, the whole thing we did with our subtracting this, that wouldn't need to be done if you had a cross section that didn't have a hole. A lot of times you're dealing with cross sections that don't have holes. They're just an I-beam or some weird cross section, but it doesn't have a hole. In that case, you don't need to do any of that stuff with the subtracting. You can just draw the outline, create a region, and then you're good to go. But if you do have a hole, you have to do the process I showed, and I wanted to show that process just in case you do have that. But again, if you don't have a hole, you can just skip that whole thing with subtracting and all of that. And again, this visual styles thing, this was just for reference. This was not necessary we did this, but it just let us confirm that indeed we did have a hole in our model, which is what we wanted. So hopefully this helped. If you have any questions, I'll leave them in the comments. And stay tuned for the video that will solve this exact same problem using SolidWorks as well. Thank you.